drive-by acting exercise. You're all angry Englishmen. Go!
I insist you tell me who sat on my crumpet.
My grandmummy went to the loo while I snogged the Prime Minister.
This flock of whippoorwills is bothering my trousers.
Good heavens! There's a dead cockroach in my brassiere.
Blimey!
Oh, I told you not to put plum sauce on me banger.
Yo, yo, sure.
Quiet down! Now that we're all Lucy and Goosey, the time has come for our newest student to tackle the bird scene! Tori, the stage is yours, though you can't take it home.
Can I ask you a quick question before I start? So...
Just do your best. Action!
Okay! It was 1934 when my husband left me. Alone. Living on the prairie was a dreary existence. No telephone, no radio. Only a large, majestic bird with whom I shared my feelings. One day when I was feeling low, I said to him, "Oh, bird, you can fly. You can soar miles from this lonely place, yet you stay. Why?" And apparently... my question rang true, for that afternoon, the bird left, and so went my spirit. How was that?
What do you mean?
Did I do the scene right?
Oh, no, not at all.
Okay, then what did I do wrong?
You'll have to perform the scene again tomorrow and get it right, or else you cannot be in Andre's play or any other.
But can you tell me what I did wrong?
No, I can't.
I don't get any feedback.
That is correct.
But...
drive-by acting exercise. You're all terrified dolphins. Go! Live the fear! Live the fear! What are you doing?
That guy was beating up Beck.
Oh, you poor thing.
We were practicing.
This is Russ.
I'm Russ.
He's a professional stuntman. I invited him here to teach the class about stage fighting.
And now Tori says,
"What's stage fighting?" I wasn't gonna say that. What is it?
Fake fighting that looks real, like for a play or a movie.
Oh.
I took a class with him last summer.
Well, it looked like he was hurting you.
Why do you care?
Because I figure he already suffers enough pain dating you.
You want to see pain?
Hey, why don't you go sit over there?
Why does she hate me?
Maybe she heard you play the French horn.
Now, if I throw a punch at Kat like this, it's easy to see that my fist didn't connect with her face.
Thank you.
But if we stage it from a different angle, then, like I showed you, sound effect ready?
All set.
To the audience or camera, it'll look like this.
I'm okay, everyone.
All right, I'm gonna pair you guys up, and each team will work with Russ this week to prepare a fight scene.
I thought his name was Steve.
He does look like a Steve.
My name is Russ.
Okay. And on Friday, you will all perform your fight scenes here in front of the class. Now, the pairs will be Beck and Kat, Andre and Gwyn, Darren and Jess, Tori and Jade.
Tori and who? Wait, I'm not comfortable with my partner.
Just a sec.
Hey, partner. I can't wait for our fight. Scene.
Gulp.
Tori, you're back. Ever thought about coming in through the window?
No.
Think about it. Now, sit. Okay, today we're going to do some alphabetical improv. What is alphabetical improv, you ask? So I answer, it's when we give a letter to the first actor who speaks in the scene. If we use the letter A as an example, then the actor must make his first word start with the letter A, which might go something like...
Apples are falling out of my butt.
Lovely. Now the next actor who speaks must start his line with the next letter in the alphabet, in this case B, so he might say...
Bring those apples so that we may all enjoy the fresh fruit from Beck's butt.
Charming. Now, who wants to lead the first group?
I do.
All right, Tori, choose your actors.
Okay, Andre, Kat, Beck, and Jade. Yeah, you.
Jade, kiss your boyfriend on your own time.
Oh, I will.
Okay, if you start your line with the wrong letter, you're out. Robbie, give us a letter.
P.
P.
Oh, I was gonna say P.
Okay, the scene can be about anything you want. The first letter of the first line is P. Tori, action.
Please go take a shower. Quit telling me what to do.
Relax, girls. Let's all try to get along.
Totally.
Kat, your line had to start with an S.
Oh, my lips.
Here's a piece of candy.
Yay, I love candy!
All right, Andre, letter S to you.
Something just bit my toe.
A turtle! That turtle just bit his toe! Unbelievable that you're even here.
Very immature of you to say that.
Come on, Andre, W!
What if the turtle bite broke my toe bone?
X-rays are the only way to find out. You should shut up.
Zap! I just healed your toe with my magic finger. Thanks.
Andre, your line had to start with an A. Sit down.
Aw, I just got my toe bone fixed.
Tori, letter A to you.
Aliens are the only people who can heal toes by finger zapping. By the way.
Correct. I am an alien.
Oh, a twist.
Don't hurt me, please. Even though she's extremely annoying.
Fainting, because I can't breathe your Earth's air.
It fainted.
Excellent. Tori and Jade, keep going. The next letter's H.
Hey, why don't you go jump off that cliff over there?
I think you should.
Just where did you come from?
Kangaroos.
Lousy animals, kangaroos. They're awkward and dirty. Maybe they learn from you.
No one talks to me like that.
Obviously someone should.
Please run in front of a bus.
Quite obnoxious of you to say.
Really?
Sure was.
Thanks!
Up your nose, I see boogers.
Very clever.
Wish you'd thought of it.
X marks the spot I'd like to punch.
Your finger smells weird.
Zero is what you are on a scale from 1 to 10.
And back to the letter A!
As if I care what you think.
Better watch yourself.
Can't take it.
Don't push me.
Eat your pants.
You eat your pants! Wait!
Sorry, Jade. The next letter was...
Yep, I know!
Keep the scene going. Letter G.
Get up, alien.
Head feels dizzy.
I know it'll make you feel better.
Jumping jacks?
Kiss me.
Let's do it.
Action.
I don't know.
Oh, come on. Why can't you admit that you're in love with me?
Why are you in love with me?
Because you're beautiful. Look at your face in the moonlight.
I can't.
You can.
No. The person can't look at their own face. It's impossible.
Then marry me and I'll buy you 1,000 mirrors.
But that's so many.
My father's a billionaire. I can give you everything you've ever wanted. And I'm very good looking.
Yeah.
Think.
And lights go?
I don't know.
It's okay that you don't know.
But you deserve an answer.
I can wait. For you, I would wait 1,000 years.
But that's so many.
I know I'm poor. I know I don't have much to offer, but I do love you.
Because I'm beautiful?
I don't love you because you're beautiful. You're beautiful because I love you.
Whoa.
I hit the wrong thing.
No! 15 years ago, your mother gave birth to the wrong thing.
All right, why don't we take a break?
Tori, Beck, you guys were great. Really nice stuff.
Thanks.
How was I?
I've seen worse.
But guys, everyone shut up a second.
What you got?
An email from Principal Eichner
that says...
To all students involved in our school's production of Uptown Downtown, Sophia Michelle will be in Los Angeles the weekend of the 17th and will be personally attending your opening night performance.
Oh my God.
Who's Sophia Michelle?
Oh, no.
What?
She gets to be the lead and she doesn't even know who Sophia Michelle is.
Wait. Is she the lady who does those infomercials with a vibrating hairbrush?
I love that hairbrush.
Look at the cover of your script.
Oh, Sophia Michelle wrote the play we're doing.
Oh.
She's like the biggest playwright on Broadway.
Oh, yeah, totally.
She's huge.
All right, you guys. We knew we had to be great. Now we have to be perfect. We are not going to disappoint Sophia Michelle.
And you're sure you want Robbie in this play?
I'm good.
At what?
I have to go take another nerve pill.
Will you kill the disco?
No one can kill disco.
Terrified.
What did you do to my pants?
Falling off a cliff.
What did you do to my pants?
Excellent! Now, as you can see, the same dialogue can evoke an infinite number of emotions depending upon how the actor chooses to play it. Like a robot!
What did you do to my pants?
Wrong! Robots don't wear pants. It was a trick. Tori, you may sit. I suggest using a chair.
I'll give it a shot.
Sorry, guys.
How was working on the movie?
You know.
Beck, you're late.
I'm sorry, we're doing the scene and there was a problem with the lighting.
Say it like a robot.
There was a problem with the lighting. I'm very sorry.
Wrong.
Wrong?
You said you were sorry and everybody knows robots don't have emotion and therefore cannot feel regret. You kids have got to do your robot research. Beck, sit. Now, as we've clearly demonstrated, dialogue can impact a scene in many different ways, depending upon Dear Gandhi, I'm boring myself. Beck, tell us all about the movie.
Okay, well, my call time was... Right. My call time was this morning at 5 a.m.
Oh, that's early!
Yeah. Well, they did my hair and makeup, and then the costume designer came into my dressing room and...
Wait, the costume designer was in your dressing room?
Uh-huh.
Was she cute?
He was adorable.
Did you meet Melinda Murray?
No, not yet.
I bet she's been stung by a bee.
I wouldn't know, but you can ask her yourself.
What?
The assistant director told me they need extras for a couple scenes, so if any of you guys want to do it...
All right, everybody read chapter 7 for tomorrow and study robots. Good Gandhi, I left my harmonica in the men's room.
Robbie, wake up.
Oh, I'm out of tissue! Oh, where is everyone?
Class is over. You slept through it.
You didn't miss nothing.
No sleep again last night?
No, I can't stop having the disturbing nightmares.
Okay, you've got to talk to Lane about this.
No! School guidance counselors are bad news. Trying to get all up in young people's heads.
He helped me get over a lot of my emotional problems.
Nah, you're still a mess.
It was in the toilet. That's a disturbing taste.
I didn't know I'd feel so awkward wearing tights.
These things squeeze me in a bad way.
Yeah, you won't be complaining when we're surrounded by lady ballerinas.
Oh, man, It's a dude ranch.
Cat. Cat.
Hey, have you seen Cat?
It's just special effects makeup.
Oh, well, that is special. And I have been affected. Yo, Cat.
Oh, hey, Tari.
We doing lunch?
Yeah, just a sec. I'm almost finished with my assignment.
Ooh, what's the assignment?
To transform a human face into a terrifying monster. Wanna see?
Terrify me.
Isn't he scary?
No, he's kind of adorable.
Ah, man, you made me cute! You're the worst!
Well, let me try again after school.
No. I'm done with you.
No, but wait, you can't just...
Done with you.
That's the third model who's quit on me. I'm gonna get an F. In makeup.
Oh, that bites. Let's go get an A in lunch.
Wait.
No. I am not gonna be your monster makeup model.
But if I don't transform someone's face into a hideous monster by Monday, I'm gonna fail this class.
And if I don't cram a turkey sandwich down my throat, I'm gonna fail not starving to death.
Come on! We can do it tonight, tomorrow night, whenever you want.
I'm in a huge play. I have to learn all my lines and 5 songs.
Tori!
What?
You have
no,
to do it.
No, I'm not doing it. I don't do it.
Yay!
But you're buying my lunch.
Aww.
Okay, if you had to give up the internet or one of your feet.
Foot.
Say foot.
Really?
You'd all give up a foot to keep the internet?
Totally.
Wouldn't you?
You love the internet.
I know, but my foot is a part of my body. And the internet is... Yeah, bye, foot.
All right, future superstars, take your seats, because at this point in your lives, I am in charge of you. Come on, hurry up. Let's not waste time. We've got some excitement today.
Yay! I love excitement.
Who doesn't love excitement?
Damien.
She's right. Tori.
Okay, so today, instead of discussing the differences...
Sorry I'm late, sweaty, and out of breath. Somebody get me some coffee.
Ravi, just sit down.
Why are you late?
Because my Uncle Marty gave me this old car, which I was really psyched about, except it keeps breaking down. And on my way here, the motor died in the middle of a really bad neighborhood. Now, don't get me wrong, I like all people, but look! A mean guy took my left shoe. And Rex's.
Put my foot down.
Okay, let's all shut up and let teacher talk. Now, I bet you are all familiar with a short film called Butterface.
Yeah, of course. Oh my God, I've watched that movie online like a billion times.
Yeah, who hasn't?
Well, I'm glad you're all aware of the film because I'd like you to meet the director of Butterface.
No way.
Don't tease me.
A former student of mine, Dale Squires. Let him hear it. Okay, Dale, podium is all yours.
Nice. I've always wanted a plexiglass podium. What happened to your shoe?
Oh, it was taken by street toughs.
Hey, is it true that you're gonna be directing Johnny Depp's new movie?
Oh, looks that way, yeah.
That even excites me.
That Dale Squires was here.
I love mass texting.
Come on. Hey, guys, you can't.
Hi, Dale. I hear you're directing the new Johnny Depp movie, and guess what? I'd be perfect. Here's my headshot.
All right, hey. If you were not in this class, then leave.
Yeah, you heard the man. Go on, get out. Gucci. Hey.
You too, Trina.
But I look so good next to Johnny Depp in a movie. Please, Dale.
Tori, can you make your sister leave?
Trina, stop embarrassing me or I'm gonna embarrass you.
Don't threaten me.
When Trina was 6, our family went to the mall just before Christmas.
Don't say it!
And she peed!
Tori!
On Santa Claus.
Thank you, Tori. Dale?
All right, what were we talking about?
In all fairness, I did have a bladder infection.
Go!
Ow! I'm so scared.
If that spider bites your eyeball, you could die in minutes.
Oh, man.
please get it off my eye?
I'm going to try. Now, shh. Don't move. And don't make a sound.
Oh, man, the ringing is back!
Segwit!
Yes!
That was a phone.
Whose?
Mine's.
Tori?
I swear I thought I had it on vibrate.
Class is no place for swearing or vibrating.
Maybe we should start the scene over.
Can we?
No, Kat, it's too late. By now that spider would have bitten your character's eyeball and you'd be dying a spastic, painful death.
Thanks a lot, Tori.
Well, we have about 4 minutes left. Why don't we all chat about our weekend plans? Robbie, I assume you have none.
I don't.
Rex?
I'm gonna partay with a couple of girls from Northridge.
Northridge girls? That should be an adventure.
What can I say?
Hey, guess what Jade and I are doing tonight? There's this new place in Los Feliz. It's called Karaoke Doki, and they have singing competitions on the weekends. So Jade and I are gonna do a song.
I'm picking the song.
Jade's picking the song.
Can Rex and I come sing too?
Sure.
I told you, I got the Northridge girls.
They can come watch.
No, man. Then they're gonna want us to buy them food and beverages.
So?
They're from Northridge. I don't want to spend money on them.
Oh, I wish I could go to Karaoke Doki.
Why can't you?
Who cares why she can't?
I was just wondering why
she... What, you need Tori around to have a good time? Is that your point?
Dude.
What?
Jade! You're lucky to have Beck. Don't be such a gank.
So, why can't you come?
No, Trina's getting her dumb wisdom teeth out today, and guess who gets to spend the entire weekend taking care of her?
Okay, is it someone famous?
No! Me!
Why can't your parents take care of her?
Because they're gonna be in Santa Barbara.
What for?
So they don't have to take care of Trina.
Can't blame them.
Shucks to be you. Gank.
Now whose phone is that?
That's the bell.
Oh. Bye!
But the most surprising part of the play happened at the end when the monster gouged out Priscilla's eyes, which for whatever reason I found really funny. Questions?
I have 2 questions.
Okay, no questions. Great, I'm done.
Thank you, Jade, for that disturbing report. Robbie, you're up.
Right. Hello, everybody.
Hi.
My report is on vaudeville. Now, if you'll all look at... Oh, my God.
Oh, your grandmother wants to chat.
Robbie! Robbie! Can you see me now?
Hi, Mama. Is this important? Because I'm kind of in the middle of...
How do I open the internet?
Mama, Mama, you're on the internet. We couldn't be video chatting if
hey,
you weren't...
Hey, Robbie! I see your puppet. Are you still taking your puppet to school?
Rex is not a puppet!
Discuss acting.
What about acting?
Oh, yes. Any questions?
One time, my brother painted part of his body purple.
Why did your brother paint part of his body purple?
He had a job interview. He didn't get it.
Wait, wait, wait! Would anyone be interested in seeing the cast list for a little play called Steamboat Susie?
Yeah.
I got the lead, right?
Pardon?
I'm playing Susie, right? Did you get the lead?
I don't think she got it.
So, who's playing Susie?
Me. Yeah. Her. That. She got the lead.
What part did you get?
I got cheated and humiliated.
You get used to it.
All right, now, chill down. Let's see. Says right here, Jade West, understudy for the role of Susie.
Oh, yee-hoo. Like, it's my dream to be Tori's understudy.
What's an understudy?
Oh, man.
An understudy is like a backup actor.
So, if you get sick or something, your understudy takes over for your part in the play.
Yeah. Yeah, if you get sick. Or go missing. Or get hit by a bus!
She can't drive a bus, right?
Then at 10 p.m., President Lincoln was watching the play at Ford's Theater. Booth quietly slipped into Lincoln's box, pulled out a derringer, and shouted,
I'm gonna kill you!
Oh, no!
Man, you better run before the girl...
Ah! Rex!
Trina, I'm teaching a class right now.
How dare you call my one-woman show a comedy?
I had to follow my conscience!
Trina! Out of this classroom.
I know where you live.
No, you don't. We moved last year.
What's your new address?
3707 Cahuenga. It's a duplex. We're on top.
Got it. I am so upset.
Man, Psychowitz is 10 minutes late.
Where is he? Maybe he locked himself in a dark closet because you forced him to go see a play that made his whole life seem like a big fat pile of garbage. I'm gonna have a banana. You know, why don't I just lie on the floor so you can start kicking me? You have that dream too?
You know, monkeys peel their bananas from the bottom.
Man, you just sit there and think to yourself, hey, what would an idiot say right now? And then that's what you say?
Oh. Hey!
Hi.
So, Psychowitz, what you gonna teach us today, I mean, I don't know what to expect, but I bet it's gonna be fantastic. Woo! All right.
Huh?
We're ready to learn.
Yeah, okay. Tori. And, Elvis. Get up on the, stage thing.
Okay.
Sure.
All right. What you, want us to do?
A scene. You both have the same line. Life is pain. So you just keep saying that to each other over and over. Do it, action.
Life is pain.
Life is pain.
It certainly is, Ding. There's the bell, class dismissed.
Way to go, Tori. You broke Psychowitz.
I did not break Psychowitz.
I did not break Psychowitz. I broke Psychowitz.
fucked up. Someone was off key.
Yeah, who was it?
Two hints, Robbie and Shapiro.
My singing was not off.
Man, your whole life is off.
Well, I think maybe Tori was off key.
Well.
Tori wasn't off. You were perfect. Really nice tone.
Handsome boy thinks I was perfect.
Uh-uh, not so fast. Let's talk about your homework assignment.
For the full moon jam?
Mm-hmm. You all have to do a song, and your performance will count as 1/3 of your semester grade.
We have to sing a solo?
It can be a solo, or you can pair up with someone in this class and sing a duet. But just solos and duets.
What about us?
No! No quartets.
So, Tori, what should we sing together?
I call Tori.
I already called Tori.
Oh, my gosh.
Are you kidding me?
She's
my
daughter. Hey, hey, hey! You guys can't just call me. I am not the front seat in your mom's minivan.
I never had a mom. Oh.
I'm singing a solo, okay?
Like the wolf.
She walks alone.
Now,
off key.
I don't want to argue with you. I just want us to be happy.
What'd she say?
What'd he say?
I can't hear.
Okay.
Take them off. See? Not so easy to perform a scene when you have a bucket on your head, is it?
No.
It's difficult.
Yes. Well, class dismissed.
But we still have more time.
We do? How much?
55 minutes.
Oh. Oh, well, actually, I do have something I need to discuss with some of you. Tori, Kat, Andre, Robbie, Jade, please stay. The rest of you, they wander the halls. Enjoy your day. Thanks for coming. I'm here all week. Tip your nurses and clowns.
Why did you make them leave?
I don't know. They never talk.
Yeah, they just sit there and react.
That's right.
You know?
They just don't talk.
So what do you want with us?
Who likes parades?
Antonio Banderas.
Hillbillies.
No one.
Oh, come on, parades are fun.
One time, my brother was in a parade, but he was inappropriate, so the parade people called the police, and now he's not allowed to be in parades. Or be near horses.
Play with the pretty keys.
KK.
So, you all know about the woman I've been dating, Felicia?
No, I don't.
Never heard of her.
Well, anyway, she's the creative director of this year's Parade Parade.
Parade Parade?
I've never heard of that.
Exactly. It's a parade to help raise awareness
of parades.
Anyway, I sort of promised Felicia I'd get some of my most creative students to build a float and perform.
In the parade parade?
Yes. So, who would like to... How about the rest of you? Would you guys like to build a float and do a little song in the parade?
Hmm?
For sweet Daddy Sykowitz?
No.
All right. If you don't want to be on national television, where all kinds of Hollywood producers and casting directors will see you, that's coodly-doo with me.
Wait.
Yes?
This parade's gonna be on national television?
Yep.
Well, if it's gonna be on national, give me my keys back. Where's my house key? I'll take her to the nurse.
I swallowed it.
We'll see it again.
You want it, you want it, you want it. You want it.
Sinjin.
Sinjin! You want...
No one wants it.
Well, with all due respect, I'd like to hear Kojeezy's opinion.
You're not my father!
Okay. Next stop is...
Cats!
Tori. Vega.
Well, I'm gonna head on out to the bathroom, because I got a better chance of hearing something good in there. Yeah. Pow.
Well, first of all, Kojeezy, I just want to say that I think you're probably the best songwriter and producer in pop music today.
Probably. So you're saying there might be somebody better than me?
This is a song I wrote last year. It's sort of a...
Play it.
And now I'll play it.
I fly, you fly, we fly like a butterfly and...
Stop.
What's the matter?
I hate butterflies.
Okay, next up is...
No, wait, no. I have another song.
Play it.
Well, you know, this song doesn't really have lyrics yet.
I'm sorry, I thought that I said play it.
Da 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 do 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 do. Na 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 oh. Na na da 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 do 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 do.
I like it. I like it a lot.
Well, okay.
Yeah, maybe flesh that out. Give it some hot lyrics. I might just buy that song.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you mind if I speak to Tori outside?
Sure. Go ahead.
I don't need to speak to you.
Oh, I think you do.
What? Ah! Hey! Why?
Don't make a scene. Don't make a scene.
You haven't seen this?
Don't make a scene.
Yes, but why? Why would a guy dress up and walk around this school blasting people in the head with flower bombs? Why?
The question no one's asking is why. Why is he doing this? Why?
Well, all I can say is that flower, it gets everywhere. Everywhere.
Come on, who could he be?
Oh, I have an idea.
What?
Talk. We make hamburgers, but wiener-shaped, right? And we put them on hot dog buns, and we call them hot durgers. I don't care, I'm gonna do it anyway.
Hey, guys. Sorry I'm late. What's up, Andre? I'm here. Start the lesson. Start.
Robbie, are you all right?
Yes! Why would you even ask that?
Because you look sloppy and your
hair looks dirty, and I don't know. You just seem all freaked out.
What? Why are you talking like that?
Why am I talking like what?
Stop it! Stop that!
Robbie, she's just worried about you.
Now, why don't you just calm down and quit acting like a fool?
Hey, are you freaked out because you sold Rex?
No! I don't need Rex. I'm a grown boy. I don't need anybody.
Oh, Robbie, everyone needs friends. Especially
weirdos like you who wear turtle pajamas like a doofbag.
Rex?
Oh, you miss Rex.
Yes. No, I don't look at me! I just need to go home. I just need to go take a nap. That's all I need to do is just go and a little rest and relaxation with you.
See, the idea is we all prepare a scene, and then we board a city bus. And as we ride along, we perform the scene for the bus passengers. Huh?
You want us to do a play for people who ride the bus?
In Los Angeles?
Sure. You'll see those bus passengers will thank us.
Yeah, by stabbing us with rusty scissors.
Wait, isn't he a famous clown?
I don't want to do a play on a bus. It's not Andre.
So none of you want to do live bus theater?
No.
All right. Ah! Then how about this? We all do the Broadway musical Annie underwater.
I don't want to do a play underwater. My skin will prune up.
None of us want to do a play underwater.
Or on a nasty bus.
I would drop it.
I see. All right. No bus play. No underwater musical. Why don't we all just lay on the floor and stick our faces in the carpet? Thusly.
What do you say?
I think he said Robbie's mother sprays his underpants with bug spray.
Rex, my mom, she's just worried that I've got roaches.
I think Psychoids is sad.
I'm not sad. Just disappointed in you children.
Why?
Because you're all a bunch of negative Nancys. Whiny Willies, depressing Darnells. Ah.
Oh, I know an old man named Parnell. His wife says things to him like, "Hey, Parnell, you want to eat some pancakes on a rocket ship?"
Nobody ever knows what you're talking about.
You have man breath.
What are you bugging about?
I'll tell you about what I'm bugging. When you kids started this class, you were all bright-tailed and bushy-eyed, hungry to learn about being performers. Now, you don't want to do nothing. I might as well just quit. I should just walk out that door, never to return. Your favorite teacher, exiting forever!
Okay, okay, don't quit, just... What do you want us to do?
Be more open-minded. You've all gotten so good at saying no. I dare you to spend the rest of this day saying yes.
To everything?
That's right.
I'm in. Jade, will you kiss me on the mouth?
You don't have to say yes to kissing or anything dangerous or illegal. But everything else, just say yes. Will you?
Yeah.
Mazel tov.
Hey, I have 143 extra Pajali Huchos at home. Who wants their very own super comfy and fashionable? Wait, Robbie. Will you wear a Pajali Hucho?
Cat.
Yes.
That'll be $19.95. Free shipping.